Please fasten driver seat belt.
Yo, my peoples, what's up? We back. It's your boys in Blue Silverback Chronicles podcast. It's your boy Big H. I got my brother Drizzy.
Cheers.
Cheers. Popping happy, bottles.
Happy everything. Excuse me. Oh my God. Happy everything.
You good, bro?
Yeah, you know, hanging and banging. That's all it. It's the tequila when
it's all good.
Snug up on me. What's up, yo?
What's good, bro?
Chilling? I see you in that crispy Blanco shirt.
Working.
Stainless.
You know what I'm saying?
I like it.
Just trying to make a change every day.
I feel you.
Absolutely. Trying to fulfill that purpose to the people. Listen, we love you guys. We appreciate you. It's episode 103, by the way. We're just working, baby. 22 is going to be a phenomenal year. Like to thank everybody for keep tuning in. Please always tell a friend to tell a friend. Don't forget Stopbox USA, 20% off. Don't forget the discount code, all caps Silverback Podcast, all caps Silverback Podcast. Don't forget my brother Charlie Schultz for Berman Sobin. They don't have Darby no more. It's Bourbon Sobin and I forgot. But it's it's the new face of the game. 410-769-5400. 410-769-5400. Call my boy Charlie Schultz. If you hurt, personal injury, or hurt at work, he's the plug, he's the go-to, he'll take care of you. What else, Dre?
That's it?
Oh, yeah.
Get into it.
And if you want a freaking phenomenal freaking t-shirt or a phenomenal freaking polo shirt, you know which website to go to, www.silverbackchroniclesfreaking.com. Get that freaking shirt. We love you, we appreciate you, and guess what? We're not going nowhere. Boys are back. We'll be here forever. What else?
That was good.
That's pretty good.
A little off the avenue.
So my freaking Zach Preppy talk, bro. Right?
Okay.
But ladies and germs, with no further ado, we got a special guest tonight. Phenomenal man's been on the job for what, almost 20 years, something like that. Sitting at 18 right now. 18, a phenomenal brother, great man. Ladies and gentlemen, no further ado, my brother, Sgt Craig. What's up, boss?
What's going on, fam? How you feeling?
I'm well. How are you?
No complaints. I want to comment on the shirt again, on that shirt again, one more time, because I want to say, you got that in my size?
Absolutely. You know, everything's sexy with the girl. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, it's all good. It's a pleasure to be here, and I appreciate the invite.
Nah, I'm glad you came through.
Hey, finally had the opportunity to get together with you and Dre. Pleasure, always.
Definitely. So, please, tell the world, where you from, born and raised? They got to know.
Flat out, I'm from Park Heights and Belvedere.
Ooh.
Born and raised.
Nice. Park Heights and Belvedere, that's Southwest, right?
Nah, Northwest.
Northwest.
That's that hot corner right there.
Absolutely. Wow. So, Baltimore raised, huh?
Absolutely.
Damn, what's the Baltimore you remember before all this violence and nonsense?
Respect.
Oh, nice.
Flat out, the Baltimore I remember no matter what I came up in, drug trade was hot and heavy, and it's funny, my first introduction to New York was actually Jamaica.
Really?
Europe, the Jamaicans tried to come down on Park Heights, take over the drug trade at the Blue Caribbean, which to this day still exists. But that was the original introduction to New York. So I had a, you know, the natural Baltimore hate for all y'all New York cats.
Like, what year was that? Like, around what year was that? Chris, can you turn me up? Like, around what year was that?
89 through 96.
That was like a war that was for that many years?
Absolutely.
89 through
96. Yep.
Wow.
Damn.
West Side drug trade. They was trying to take over.
Jamaica's, that shit was just like marked for death.
Almost 10 years.
Who did it? The white boy Atcha? I want Atcha dead!
But the thing you find out crazy when you grow up in an area like that and you grow up in that community, it's kind of funny when you sit back and look at it because the young kids was never allowed to see what really happened, what really went on. The only time you would see anything that went on behind the doors was if you had family that was directly involved. But even then, it was just that level of respect that was given. That's how I say. What we lost is respect. That's the difference I see now. Violence is violence. It don't go nowhere. Just how we cover it or how we shift it to the side, left or right.
That's what's up.
But we lost respect across the board.
What high school did you go to?
I went to a few.
How come everybody in Baltimore goes to different high schools? Like,
we grew up with really fucked up tempers.
That's crazy.
Nice.
They be like, yo, you call me a B, yo.
And then you get kicked out.
Yeah, throw people through
windows. Call me all types of B's, yo.
Crazy stuff.
It's like,
they call me all types of B's.
The feel I get is high school was like, it was like a famous college. It's like, what high school did you get? It's more talked about what high school you went to.
Yeah.
It's like that. That's the representation of that individual.
That's the East Side thing.
Oof.
If you ever notice, you ever hear, it's East Side schools that do that real heavy. You get it sometimes on the West Side, but it's usually an East Side thing. Because most of the time, everybody on the West Side went to an East Side school, got thrown out of the West Side school, back to the East Side school, then thrown out again.
Damn.
Then you end up in the county.
How about that? So where'd you finish your high school years at?
Finished my high school years in Randallstown.
Really?
In the county.
Okay. In the county.
Yep, in the county.
That's dope.
As they say, started at Lake, East Side School, got thrown out of Lake, went to Northwest, got thrown out of Northwest. They was like, all right,
go away. Thrown out for what?
Enough is enough, pal.
Fighting.
Just fighting, always fighting. But everybody fights.
I had a bad temper.
Oh.
I never knew how to stop.
They had enough of you.
Pretty much, yeah.
Yeah.
Prince was like, if I see him again, he going to jail.
You got voluntold, you got to go.
Dude, you got voluntold.
How about that?
You got voluntold.
Had a lot of great conversations with her, though. Great lady.
All right, so what you do after high school? Any career aspirations, like leaving high school?
Left high school, went to the military.
What branch?
Army.
Nice.
Got out of the military. Phew, good God. Then I started, literally, I got out the military at 20 and went to the department, actually.
Curious, how many years did you serve in the military?
I did 3 years active, and then I got out, came to police, and then I went back in the National Guard.
Nice. So how did life prepare you for the military?
Absolutely did not.
It didn't. So let me guess, they had to mold you.
Oh, you had to hit me in my head. They had to hit me in my head enough times for me to get the point. To be honest with you, the greatest thing I'll tell anybody, especially inner city kids, military gives you a basis. It gives you a basis to teach you the respect that we grew up with, and it teaches understanding why things are the way they are. First thing the military teaches: hurry up and wait. Most annoying thing in the world, but it teaches you a level of patience and control that you never even thought that it had a reason for.
That is a great point.
It seems crazy.
Because hurry up and wait happens everywhere, like in real life.
Absolutely. You ever notice that? No matter what you do in life, you always hurrying up to wait. So the military forced it into you. Then it teaches you a bunch of bad habits.
It's okay.
You know the normal. Drinking. Absolutely. Womanizing. Having fun. Bad habits.
I don't think that's a bad habit.
You just can't OD on it. You know?
Absolutely.
Yeah, you know.
Balance. After that, then I came on the department, I think 20 and a half.
So why leave the military?
Always wanted to be a cop, believe it or not.
Really?
Yep.
Why the lovely city of Baltimore?
So, told you, I grew up on Park Heights in Belvedere. And one of the things I grew up, I had an instant hate for drugs. Majority of my family was on drugs at the time. They either were on it or selling it. So that was the only thing I knew growing up, majority of the time. And that's all I really saw. So it was that pull of, I don't want to be like that cat. Because I never had that dependent personality where I wanted to use anything or do anything. We all did what we did as a kid, but it was never that I needed to. Heroin was never my thing. Never wanted to be lean on the junkie. And I thought it was a weakness in character. I thought when you got that point where you getting high like that, your character's just weak. And it never made sense to me. So then you go back to the point of when respect started to change. So looking at your family where I had an older cousin who was heavy in the game, and he was like, nah, you can't do this. Keep it out of it. But then when he got popped, sticking up and keeping his word for his man, it was like, all right, I see it. It's a balance. It's all a business. So the differentiation of if I'm going to be a good cop or a bad cop, the differentiation of understanding the difference between the style of cops And I think that's when I really felt that love. I was like, man, yo, they smart. They figure out the game. Because, you know, being in it, growing up in it, you see the hustle. You know how to move. You know how to stash. And then doing this as a career, you see it more. So imagine seeing both sides of it. And you go, damn. You see the cat and mouse. And in truth, ain't nothing more fun than hunting man.
Absolutely. 100%. That's what I'm talking about.
That's so the what's best more job in the world. Mm.
So that's what drew me in.
Damn.
There's nothing better than that.
It's not. People tell, like, they ask me all the time. What
There's
is
a it? Quote. There is a quote.
Actually, yeah. I can't remember who did that. That is a famous quote, isn't it?
Is it Oswald? I have it in my phone.
Look it up, Triple C.
Yeah. He said there's nothing like greater than hunting a man.
And I think you don't comprehend that till you actually do it.
Yeah.
And to clear it up, I ain't talking about hunting to shoot nobody or kill nobody. I'm talking about the excitement of the chase.
Right.
The excitement of figuring it out and then narrowing it down.
Yeah, that's Ernest Hemingway.
Ernest Hemingway.
What's
the quote?
There is no hunting like the hunting of man. And those who have hunted armed men long enough and liked it, never care for anything else thereafter.
That's the second part.
Absolutely. Fire.
Those that hunt armed men, that's the key.
Big difference.
Yeah, because, I mean, yeah.
Yo, you got to have an A-type personality to do this job, and you got to be psycho enough and okay enough to chase somebody that has a gun.
Yeah.
You know what kills me? I have fun with it. Is, you know, we all come from the hood, but you see the hood dudes and they see that shit and they look at you like, well, motherfucker, you get paid to do it, go get them.
That's the best part of the day.
But you know, damn right, they ain't going to chase that motherfucker with the gun.
Best part of the day, though.
Best, but it's like, yo, it's a rush. And it's oh man,
like,
it's
like chasing a person with
nothing.
A gun.
Yo, it's different.
I wish we could go back to that.
What?
Because you will see the difference in the numbers. Crime will go down.
It will go down.
You know
crime
why?
Will go down.
Because, it, like I say, yeah, I love it. Crime goes down because what they see is that respect.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. They see a true predator and they like understand this, what a predator is.
Right. Like, this dude does not care.
They know what we are. Like, I love when we sit back and we have these conversations and we sit back and we go, the good old days. And
the
it's
good
funny.
Old days, yeah.
We under 20 and we had this conversation like, man, it's
crazy?
Changed that much.
Facts. Because we're in our 11th, you in your 18th.
Yeah.
And then the amount of change.
Yes.
And then the thing that kills me the most is when I sit back. So I laugh because people that don't know your history compared to people that do. So now, you know, where I work at now, I'm out of operations, which kills me softly some days.
I bet it does.
And it's funny, these young cats come at you ahead, these war stories. And you going, bro, that was my Monday.
Facts.
What are you saying to me right now? And you know, we ain't going to throw no names. I don't want but you hear these kids coming up to you. Yeah, I had the guy and we were sitting there tussling for 30 seconds. I ain't know if they was ever going to come. You going, 30 seconds? Bro, you ever roll with a motherfucker for 2 minutes?
How about that?
In the middle of the 4x4 rolling with a cat.
It's different.
Do they understand that?
No.
You in the house when they close the door on you.
Regular old dangling.
You know? Ready on your back, you trying to figure out where is that?
Where's that? Because
you know the sign.
You running, can't find the motherfucker. It's flying everywhere.
You still got to keep eyes on them.
Yo, like I say, it's no greater pleasure truly sit back and do police work.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Real police work.
And that's why I say, when you said that comment about alphas, and that when you talk about the silverbacks, when you talk about a wolf pack, all you're talking about is animals that rule the animal kingdom in that field. Not only do they rule it, but they hunt in a pack.
Mm.
And that pack is always clean. It's neat. It's efficient.
It's organized.
It's beautiful.
And they take care of each other.
And that's what we lost.
Yeah. Exactly.
That's
what happens when you try to cater to people.
Right. You can't make everybody happy.
You can't cater in police work.
You can't.
I'm sorry.
You definitely can't.
This is not where it's all traffic tickets and no.
Oh, it's not? I thought this whole time all we do is pull over cars and harass people. That's not what you do.
Yo, shout out to all those gun dogs out there, man.
Word.
All those dudes out there that's still getting
keep
it.
Keep getting it in.
Absolutely.
I love it.
I admire you guys because you guys are still putting guns on the table.
Y'all take a risk that we don't even understand anymore.
Yeah.
I mean, we used to get guns, but we ain't. Yeah.
Yeah,
I mean, now they're doing much smarter. You know,
they are. I give it that. I do.
But still, though,
I applaud it.
Yeah.
I got to agree with you. It's a lot smarter.
They do a lot of technology, investigations. Yeah. You know, because that's what you have to, but it's nothing like pounding.
You know what I miss? I miss getting in the car stop. Foot chases.
Yes. Mm.
And this SWAT, and this SWAT hear it, they key up, and you in a foot pursuit with SWAT, they running next to you. Yeah. Getting motherfuckers this behind us. Oh, I'm missing.
That mob chase.
Shout out Sergeant Scott Steven. That's my man. Love you. I remember my first foot, not even my first, but we was in the chum. And we got a call for a dude with a gun. It wasn't us, another unit. So we hear the unit. He's keying up in the radio, but you can hear he's breathing hard because he's running. He's trying to give a description.
Mm-hmm.
So we in the area. And it's like, yo, we all just converged in this one area. And I see Scott Big Ass running from SWAT. And I see other units, and we find it. Where's he at? He's in the back of this shed. But it's dark out, so you really can't. Motherfuckers lasering everybody. We trying to figure out, get him, I see him. We get him on the ground. He's like, yo, I give up. But yo, Scott hopped over the, it was crazy. But it's just, I miss that. Like that rush.
Yeah, it was dope.
Of getting somebody that has a gun.
But you notice what you also identified in everything you just said? That camaraderie.
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Remember your first foot chase? The first one. And they used to look at you. You going to sound like a bitch on the radio.
Yeah.
No, I'm good, man. I got right. That. I'm going out of that right now.
Oh, nine. Where's that officer at? Where's that unit at? Raise him up. Key him up. Where's he at?
Make sure he's good.
Exactly.
Right.
And hell it's like yeah. Your chest beating through your damn vest.
But you didn't even worry because you knew the shift was coming.
You didn't care about it.
My first day in the Southwest. My Calvary. Southwest.
Absolutely. Well, nothing better than hear that sound.
What? Hell yeah. My first day in the Southwest in field training, I got to a foot chase. I had no idea where I was at. And absolutely. I was in the tri-district.
Remember, that was the norm.
And I was like, this is the greatest shit ever. It was dope.
It's no feeling.
Real quick about your boys, Stevens. First time I meet him, right? Rookie year. We're in SWAT. We used to hold our roll call in SWAT. So we there. They were not happy that it's like these yellow jackets are in their roll call room.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They were not happy. This dude walks out in a towel. He just came out of the shower. And back then, he was really big.
Yeah. No, Scott from Minnesota.
Just a big ram. Yeah, basically.
Right.
So he shows up. We sitting there. We like, you know, joking around. Like, yo, today how many lockups are you going to get, man? And
we hear the door close
and everybody looks behind. And there was a microwave. My bulldog twin, Leventhal, he put a breakfast sandwich in that joint. So he was just standing by. Mm-hmm. He's listening to everybody, standing by the microwave. We all talking, we turn around, we hear the door slam. He walks in like water still on him.
Yeah.
Towel. Looks at the whole room. Looks at the microwave, opens the microwave, grabs the sandwich that did not belong to him,
right.
Turns around
and walks out.
No, faces us,
eats
unwraps it.
Oh, shit.
Bites it.
Yeah.
Looked at us, and we're all like, what the fuck is going on?
Scott's nuts.
My buddy standing right next to me.
You fucking know, bro.
And I'm like, yo, you ain't gonna say that. He was like, I'm fucking too
let
big.
It go, sir.
He just walked out, yeah, and I was like, it. Oh. God, welcome damn. To Baltimore.
Yeah.
This is
that's my guy. Life. Shout out. I seen him in service like a month ago, two months ago.
But shout out to V and SWAT.
Yes. Everybody.
He's still getting it in. All those hitters. Dudes are still.
Yeah. Leotis. Oh, yeah. Armor.
Think about it.
You all the crew, down, man.
Dog, I had the opportunity. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just
you can go down the list.
Just brilliant. And not only, people think like, oh, they're SWAT. They're just, you know, muscle. No, I've sat in one of the, I had the privilege to sit in one of their briefings.
Oh, Braggs too.
Oh, yeah, Braggs.
Shout out to Braggs. Of course.
What was he, 30? Episode 30?
I forget. He did 2 episodes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I sat there and I got to listen to these highly skilled men.
Mm-hmm.
And they were, you know what they spoke about? How can they do that better? And nothing happened. They got it. They was a 2 hits. It went down. No, you know, no casualties, no nothing, mm-hmm. no incidents. They went down peaceful and they were still like, what can we do better?
Yep.
I was like, I'm fucking proud of the fucking SWAT.
That's what they do. And you know, experts at it.
They spoke about it. They were like, you know, next time maybe we can hit this window. We can look at it from this angle. And I'm like, yo, that's dope.
And you know the crazy part about, I'm sorry, part about the respect that I love about it is you notice the lowest man, the newest man is allowed to speak to the elders and give his idea. And his
they birth, don't care.
His respect.
Yeah.
Because they all feel as though the only way for us to learn is that equality and understanding.
Yeah.
I mean, just because you're a rookie, you can still see something I ain't see.
Yeah.
And that's what they give you that opportunity to speak on it.
And that's the way it should be.
And it's not about an attack. It's going, all right, I see what you're saying. But do you think this, to hear that in a conversation, it's amazing to see
how it is. It's beautiful.
When they break it down.
It's beautiful. I love everything about their demeanor. I love how they're men's men.
Because they're still a team, bro.
But there's nothing selfish about them.
Nothing.
And they enjoy looking evil in the eyes.
Absolutely.
Like they enjoy, I remember a SWAT officer last year. Took the suspect down. Suspect caught him like in the chest, then the shoulder. Continue fire, put the suspect down, talking calm and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Talking calm as he's got like two bullets in him. And he's like, yeah, I'm okay.
That's next level.
Yeah. Yo, it's next level. Leaking out and putting the tourniquet on by itself. Like, yeah, I'm good.
Yeah, I'm
just,
good.
Just get me to the hospital. I'm ready.
But meanwhile, you know, you get your gangsters, they get shot in the toe, and they in the
this
hospital, like,
crying, hollering
and I'm
shit.
Saying that, like, dog, who shot you? They're like, ah, yeah, yeah. And I'm like, fam. Like, recently, I was SWAT, like, over the summertime, or right before the summertime. This dude, they make entry. Bunker takes one round, mad calm.
Yeah.
He's like, we're going to back up. And I'm like, what? Wow. You hear them.
And a firefight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And a fight. They didn't return rounds because, no. You know, because they have to, nowadays you can't.
Yeah.
They couldn't identify the target. Like, all they did, pull back out.
Yeah. We're just going to back out and left him to get tired. Yeah. And I was like, what?
Before we make
it. It's beautiful. It's beautiful.
It's insane.
That's why police work is still the best job out there, man.
I love it.
I hate to admit every it, but yeah, it still it. Is.
It still lie. Is.
I hate to admit it some days because some days I'm like, what the hell am I doing?
I know. I feel you.
I'll be the first one to say the people that never done the job are the ones that are making the decisions and they need to. I think it's time because as you can see that in society in every city right now, the numbers are through the roof. Have you seen Philly?
Yeah.
They got like 505 murders, bro.
Question. But you ain't here.
Executing
you
women.
State's attorney. We ain't got no issue. We ain't got a crime problem in Philly. Come and visit. Kind of sound like ours. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yo,
we ain't got no issues, guy. Look, crime everywhere. Is a 5 to 10 year problem, gentlemen.
The whole country has issues right now with this crime thing.
It's not an issue. We're all understanding and coming together. We're gonna walk through it in peace.
Yeah, we're gonna talk
kumbaya all the way.
You know, and what kills me is that these politicians or whoever it may be, they don't understand that like these criminals know what they're doing, and there's certain cops that they respect, and they go up to them like, yo. You know what? Today I'm going to take a long lunch break.
You remember those days?
Yeah. That happens.
That was respect.
Yeah. Do you remember those days?
That's what I do.
Yeah, that's what I was
do you
saying.
Remember
was
those days?
Respect. It goes where back to what you were saying.
It's your post. How many times 11, 13, 15 posts?
Yeah.
How many times you was 13 and 15 on a night?
That's us.
All by your lonesome.
That's it.
So, what you had to go.
Left to control your all that.
First hour, you rolled through, right or wrong.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Now, yo, Cliffmont.
Hit all the hot spots.
Snake right through. Good.
4x4. Bel Air, man.
You see I'm working.
I'm out here tonight.
Snake through all the hot zones. What happened?
That's it.
Hey, guys.
Mm-hmm. They see you go, oh, yo. All right, I got you.
Yeah.
That was a good conversation.
You know what happened? I feel like the bitch-ass criminals, not the real criminals, because the real criminals, I'm not even going to call them. Yes, they commit crimes, but they approach it from more like a business.
Yeah.
It's the whiny little fucking,
loud
I
want to
sell drugs for Jordans. Yeah. I want to sell drugs because this is the rap music.
Yeah.
Those are the ones that fucking ruin the game because all they do is cry.
Mm-hmm.
Why am I going to jail? And then not only that, but then they rap on their competition. But, you know, that's the difference.
Yeah.
Can't even go there. Then, like you said, then we in this There's game no where
yeah.
Then we in this game where we have. So I'm gonna talk about our Big H, real quick. So I met the man on multiple occasions. I'm gonna give it from both angles real fast. Mm-hmm. So I was one of them cats. I don't believe in the outside at all. I don't, because I feel as though you can't know this city if you ain't been in this,
especially this town. Especially this
when time. I mean Baltimore specific.
100%.
You don't comprehend Baltimore from any other location unless you in it.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all came from the hood. Everybody in this room came from the hood. but it's a different level. Mm-hmm. When you came to Baltimore and seen the hood and went, oh shit.
Oh yeah, this is different.
You went, yo, what the fuck is this? Like, we go all the way back to not just the accent. We go up north, I got a country accent. I go down south, they're like, bro, you sound northern. Mm-hmm. So you work it in between. That's literally what Baltimore has always been. We've been a staple city, and that's always how it's been. We stand alone and always has. That's why I laugh when you get these experts to go, you can do it like Chicago. You can do it like Philly. No, you can do it like New York. No, you can't. It's a whole different beast. Oh, in L.A., this is what we do. This ain't L.A., bro.
This ain't L.A.
You see when the L.A. boys came down here, what happened?
You see every time. You see every time one of them visit here, what they go? They go, missing.
Yeah.
Oh.
They still looking for those people.
Oh.
No matter how the boys came through.
So let me jump back on Big H real quick. So Big H is toted as a progressive. He's an understander of the consent decree, moving forward, progressive. He understands law enforcement. Now, if you look at the guy's record historically, he was a legitimate cop. I mean, he got it in New Orleans. He got it in. No BS. Look up his record. Dude was a legitimate cop. The problem is, like any person that get to a certain rank, and you had a past guest that we all look up to as a leader. We all look up to as a cop's cop. Mm-hmm. 30 plus years here. Grinded all day. Mm-hmm. But he didn't get the opportunity to truly excel at what he did. But then when we speak of one of our greatest commissioners, everybody states one name. Norris. New Yorker. But the first thing he did when he came to Baltimore was like, hey, we're going to police like Baltimore police. That's what he presented. That's how he brought it. That's how he carried it. Big H was brought for one reason. Consent decree. Get it under compliance. And in the process, now you got to look at the things he did in a positive way. Over the past, 3 years? Our technology has went through the roof.
That's what, absolutely.
Say whatever you want. Our technology is 100%.
No, I agree with you.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But I mean, he came here to check a block. And he was honest. He was like, hey, crime here. That's a 5 to 10 year issue.
Word.
What commissioner lasts more than 5 years?
Yeah.
So did he not just state, that ain't my problem? He didn't say, I don't care. He just said, that's not my problem. That's why I'm not hired. But the problem is, we as Baltimoreans, we as real cops. We was gunners. We was runners. That's what we know. And all we've seen is morale shatter. But I don't blame that on him, because he is a politician. That's his job. Mm-hmm. That's his career path. That's what he is here for. But tell me what our union do. Had that thought in conversation. Mm. How respected is our union right now in this city? In the state. But we fire off at Big H. That dude had one. He ain't Baltimore. He ain't BPD other than the uniform. Tell me I'm lying. But everybody in our unit that run it is in uniform, right? What'd they do? So who do we really target and who do we really go after? Are we questioning the right people?
I mean,
that's when I talk about, when we talk about morale, is the morale a commissioner's issue or a union issue?
I feel like, honestly, I don't even think it's a union issue, because the union has to deal with certain amount of conversations or certain pressures that we're not even privy to. Like, the shit that goes on in those rooms, like, is so far beyond us that we can't even comprehend right now. The shit that goes on and why and who. I feel like the morale has to be on us.
Agreed. So where do we start from?
I mean,
when we call it on us, so every day you go out and you grind hard. Not only do you go out and grind hard, but you represent, both of y'all represent who we are in this every day.
I feel like there's a lot of issues, but like one of them is these new officers, they're not like us.
Of course not.
They want to go look cute, tick tock, whoop, bop, go home. Us, we trying to stay. Oh, you staying? Bet I'm staying.
Absolutely. That's what
we want. See what I'm saying? And then we rock out another 8 hours and we have fun. And that's what makes us better cops, because like anything else, you need more repetition in doing it.
Agreed.
You coming in doing 8 hours and you think you're a phenomenal cop, you're not going to get this game.
You don't learn it.
You got to be in this game every fucking day as much as you can in order to understand the severities of certain calls or how your man sounds when he's in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
But you can't get that if you want some just...
I'm in and out.
Oh, you TikToking?
Yeah. Well, oh, yeah, that bullshit.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out to whoever. I don't care. You can TikTok all you want. But remember, while you looking at your phone doing all these cute shit, the block is watching you look dumb.
Absolutely.
That's not community policing, in my opinion.
Oh, that's not? You don't think so?
I mean, dancing looking dumb is not.
When I pop up my new video on TikTok, man, you hating, man. I'm throwing my new TikTok video. I ain't got a good TikTok with no video.
I'm dancing the hood, but ain't gonna be on TikTok. You know what I'm saying? I like to dance. We always to put music on and
you
dance.
You know all day I feel exactly what you're saying, and I do agree with you.
Yeah.
But
these kids, they don't understand morale.
My issue is these kids, like you said, they don't understand morale and they're simplistic. They in and out quick hitters. That's all they really know and that's all they look at right now is how I feel about it. And that's what I'm saying. And that's across the board. I sit here and laugh. You all remember 11 years ago, 18 years ago, when you first came in, you got the worst motherfucking car ever. And you know I talk from experience on this one. When I hear cats talking about, oh, can I get the new one? What the fuck?
Gotta earn that, homie.
Bro, that come with that come with time, effort. What you doing, cat?
I still believe in that.
It's required. Cut your bones. 100%. Earn your right.
Earn your right.
I agree with that 1,000%.
But it, like I said, they're so far gone and they have a completely different breed. Like, I ain't seen this many college educated kids in law enforcement my entire life. Man. Just like, I'm sorry, policing, because law enforcement, we don't enforce anything anymore. So police, I'm sorry. We right. Police, right?
Police intrusive.
We can't be law enforcement anymore. No. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Give us some tickets.
Policing. We got police. So in our policing, you got more degrees and masters. I'm like, damn.
Which is dope. Which is dope.
Cool. It's nothing wrong with having an education.
Right.
But if you don't understand the basis of how to do this, what good are we doing right now? Like you said, if you're not cutting your bones, if you're not digging in.
Whatever college you went to ain't going to learn you, ain't going to teach you how to run Mayfield and Bel Air.
Absolutely.
That's all I'm saying. Whatever college, I guarantee you, I don't give a fuck if you went to MIT, fam. You come down to Bel Air and fucking Ehrman, your degree did nothing for you.
Oh, and there's I love no when they
call you. You gotta learn how to respect. You gotta learn how to talk to who. You gotta learn how to recognize who's what. That MIT degree ain't gonna do. You might just go bang on a computer. That's serious. You gotta get out the car, like Ace says. You gotta get out the car.
You got to.
Degree or no degree, you gotta get out the car.
And they not built like that no more.
You gotta get out the car.
They not looking, like you said, they not looking for that excitement we have. And then you don't get alphas no more. You see what's coming through.
You know, we've been.
You don't get no alpha. Nah, you ain't getting the alpha no more.
Can't do that. That's overly aggressive.
I believe that. I think it is, but I think that's not true.
No, you can't be aggressive in this.
You
society.
Can't be aggressive, but I mean, you can still be.
It's got to be.
It better fucking come back.
You know, it's got to be. Looking at 5 to 10 years, brother. 5 to 10 years.
You know what it's going to be? It's got to be appropriate aggression.
Absolutely.
It's gonna happen.
He said that with the talking sexy.
He did it with the deepness.
Like appropriate aggression.
Yeah. It does, though. I agree. It does have to be appropriate aggression.
It's a skill set.
We still can police how we want to police.
We can.
It's just all in preparation.
But then we go. I'm ahead of target. You always go on. But then it goes on the frontline leader. You got 3 week command old sergeants staff. Nowadays.
No.
You got commanders with less time on than y'all.
Facts.
I don't know.
I see the John sequence. I said, "Ooh,
yeah." And there's people, you know,
with a white shirt.
Yeah, it's dangerous.
Whoa,
it's dangerous because police.
Like, homie, you might be good on that computer
all day,
but you ain't good at guiding and leading like that.
I aced that test. Stop hating. You gonna listen to me? I'm an expert on that test.
Oh my god,
that test ain't real life.
Look, I ain't never been on Mayfield, but I'm gonna ace that test right there. Stop hating. Now, matter of fact, you go on Mayfield and tell them guys clear the corner.
Dog, I showed up to a shooting at, what's the hospital in the Northwest? Sinai?
Sinai.
And there was a sergeant there. And I'm like, hey, Sarge, where's your officer looking at the body, like watching?
Where's your primary?
He's like, I don't know. I said,
What?
I said, all right. I said, what's the victim's name?
He's like, I'm waiting on that information.
You waiting?
I said to my sergeant, who's our bro, yeah. I said, Sarge, you gotta talk to this guy. I'm about to curse this dude out.
Let's rewind.
And I'm a detective, but he's a sergeant.
We going to go back. Waiting.
The sergeant was waiting, but the body was there, but he was waiting on the name.
When the fuck we wait?
Fucking guys. Guy sitting on the table, his fucking eyeball falling out. And we're waiting on a name. And so I'm like, but you're the sergeant, though.
I forgot. We don't run pockets no more to get ID? We don't ID victims no more?
You're going into somebody's pocket. You can't do that.
He a victim. We don't do that
There's
no more?
There's blood on there.
Oh, shit. I don't want to get blood on my hands.
There's blood on there.
And it's Sinai. You know, the nurse hand you the whole bag now.
Mm-hmm.
They even hand you the wallet with the ID hanging out. Like, here you go. Damn.
I said, Sergeant, talk to the sergeant, because I don't want to, at the time, you know, I was going through all that shit. Mm-hmm. I'm like, I don't want to get try to get another charge of insubordination. So you talk to him, please. And it was, I was just like, so then I go up to him. I'm like, hey, how long you been a sergeant? He's like, yeah, man, I got tired of getting fucked for not getting the vacation book. So I took the test. And I was like,
wow.
That's your reasoning
for becoming
because you want more days so you could go home, fucking rub on your cat and play Xbox.
How you know he ain't got a dog? Why you
fuck hating? You?
Damn. Ain't nothing wrong with a golf.
I was like, fuck this guy. That's not for the profession. That's for self.
Yeah, that's where we at.
Selfish, man.
You can't fucking guide. You never been in it.
Exactly. But that's feel as though that's the example they want
to
set.
I mean, shout out to all those young sergeants. I feel you. You want to progress.
But progress for a reason. If you want to be a leader for a reason.
Right.
Understand and comprehend your job.
Yeah, don't just do it just because you want days off.
Yeah, that's that bullshit.
Because if you really think about it, you can really kind of get your days off. It's not really that big of a deal.
If you want to supervise like that, like just go to Adam Schiff or something.
But don't even go to Adam Schiff now. Nah, we can't even do that no more. You got to say it right. Go to Baker Schiff now.
All right.
Go to Baker Schiff. You can't go on Adam Schiff.
Go Adam Schiff, the way jump off again. Be that busy, yeah. Bro.
Adam Schiff, jump off again. Nah.
Adam should be jumping off.
Oh yeah, you ain't gotta look at. You gotta look at it now. You still get your alerts, right?
Are you ready to get back out there to run the district?
Unfortunately, bro, I'm hungry again.
Oh yeah,
I miss it.
Do you?
I miss it. I ain't even gonna lie. I miss
your shirt gonna be different though.
Why you gotta talk? Why can't we leave?
Just saying.
Look, you know as well as I do.
If you get back out there, I'm just saying.
I'm gonna hit the line that I was told. I'm abrasive. So my shirt will probably still be blue. Oh, I'm abrasive. You got to remember that keyword. I had to learn that in my meeting.
You should get a blue shirt with white stripes. Fuck the game up on them, right?
Word.
I mean, with the white ball or something like that.
Word, get the white bars put on there.
Y'all talking shit. I was reading the policy trying to find a loophole. I was trying to find a loophole. Like, fuck. Can't do the carrier. Can't do the polo.
Damn.
Looking for a loophole. But nah, I ain't even going to lie, bro. I miss it.
Do you?
When I say I miss that chase. I still fiend for that shit.
Mm.
Like if anybody ever asked me I always want to go back to CID. It's nothing better than putting your mind against another motherfucker.
The mind aspect of that is dope. I'm happy I get to do that.
Building a case, walking a scene, having a conversation with a victim.
Shout out to everybody, you know, playing that CID.
Absolutely.
Game.
Yeah.
That to me, that's an art form. And you know, it we got certain arms. People in our agency that's
facts.
Gods at it. Masters. I'm talking, there's people, I've had the pleasure of working with some of those people and just to listen to them, good God.
Brilliant minds.
Yeah, like to hear a conversation with some people
in
that interaction, I still love that. I ain't gonna lie, I love it and I miss it.
Yeah.
Mm.
When you honestly ask, I miss it. No bullshit.
That's what's up.
That's always, like, we always talk about that chase is what matters.
Yeah.
For me, of course, chasing a gun, riding around with you, of course, but like, ain't nothing like getting somebody in that box.
Thank you. That one-on-one I love it.
That interrogation, no gun. Ain't no gun. You don't have handcuffs. So I don't got a gun.
Look, I got his. It's all about that conversation.
Mm.
That's that day, bro. That makes a day. When you build up from nothing.
And get everything out.
Got him on there. Yo, I ain't do it, but so you went over there, man? I mean, what's good with you? Look, man, I know he was talking that bullshit to you. I mean, come on now. Come real with me. Matter of fact, yo, you want something to drink real quick? Let me grab you something. We're going to chill out real quick. You call your girl? Mm. Matter of fact, I'm going to grab your phone so you can call your girl. Walk out, grab the phone, hand it to him. Start putting in his coat. Oh, shit. Let me check with my sergeant real quick. Let me get that. And it's legal.
Mm.
Just unlock this shit. Right or wrong? Is it not? That's the challenge.
This department, there's so many tricks to the trade.
That's fun, bro.
And it's sophisticated.
Like I said, when you sit there, like my hunters, shit like that, when you see that and compare yourself to having that comprehension, that understanding with an individual, that's amazing.
And it's so dope to get like someone that's like, you know, has done it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, he's playing the game too.
And you ain't got nothing but that conversation right now. All you got is, you know, he was there.
And it's, y'all just going back and forth.
And you just sit there and the best part is, what everybody don't understand, I think the greatest thing I ever learned, let them talk. Give them enough to get them open. The worst person in the world in a box is a person that don't want to talk. That's the worst thing to deal with. But once you get them talking, if you can get them talking, that's all you got to do.
Mm.
that, like I said, that's that hunt. That's Quiet what boy. I evolved to.
Yeah. Let it all out.
Absolutely. They sing.
I mean, it's not that like they're telling, it's just that they don't know that they're telling.
Yeah, they just talking.
They're just talking. Like, you have built such a rapport that they feel so confident.
That they want to give you whatever. And don't know that they're giving you the grit, the goods.
Yeah, and it's just like, oh, so my you man, were there.
I appreciate you.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. oh. Then you oh, yeah, I was there. I was getting a slice. Oh, okay.
Then you take Are that you conversation, hungry? Match it to their phone.
Yeah.
Then you keep the next part of the conversation. Oh, so you don't talk to them, but didn't you call them? Yeah, I mean, yeah, I don't really fuck with them like that, but yeah, I did call them real quick.
Yeah.
You just build that case. That's, like I said, that's that chase when we talk about. That's, I think, was the evolution from chasing cats with guns, from chasing cats in the car. That, to me, was the evolution. That's what gave that challenge back to what we do. Mm. And I've never lost that love, man. I ain't gonna lie. That's what I miss.
Yeah, you know, like being in the box.
I ain't gonna lie. That's what I miss.
You know, it's such a rush for different things that we do on this job. I remember I had a partner, and I know he wasn't with the shits like that, but he was game. You mm-hmm. know what I'm saying? And he wrote out. They wanted him to ride out with me one day, so we got a domestic call. And the boyfriend, this big dude, he's beating on his old lady. And it got to a point where she was just done. She was done with him. She was done. But she never wanted to write nothing on him.
Mm-hmm.
But that, I guess that day, me talking to her. So, I separated them.
Yep.
I said, yo, take dude. I said, bro, do me a favor. The boyfriend.
Mm-hmm.
I said, go in the other room, my partner. I said, let me just, you know, you got a hot head. I know she's upset. She hot right now. I said, just, let's calm down.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, nah, I got you, big bro. I got you. I said, yeah, just go chill over there for a minute. So I got her. I said, what's going on? What happened? She let it all out.
Mm. Ain't that amazing feeling?
She let it all out. She started crying. I said, listen. I said, you don't got to deal with this. I said, look at you. You beautiful. Why you let somebody put their hands on you? I said, listen, I'm here for you.
Mm-hmm.
What's going on? She gave me everything. So he was a convicted felon.
Mm-hmm.
And he had a gun in the room.
See? Conversation.
Let it all out. So I said, where's that? She wanted to go grab it. I said, yeah, don't do that, though.
Mm-hmm.
Stop.
Look, he said, slow down. Slow down. Let me make a call.
I said,
first.
Listen, where's that, though? She said, so I said, do me a favor. I said, just point, where's that? I said, chill right there.
Oh, wait, you gotta be careful. You're talking about real police work.
Right.
You gotta be careful.
Wait, right. Real police work don't sound like that.
Right?
Whatever happened to the freezing?
Right. Oh, and jacking people up on the corner?
How about that?
And running their pockets and taking their money? I mean, that ain't the police
Get
work
on
I
the
know.
Floor.
That's the shit I know.
Absolutely.
So, well, go ahead, because that's
not what I'm saying. It sounds sexy, right?
Yeah, it sounds like a.
So we got a domestic porn. Call. That turned into a convicted felon. That's got a gun with him. And he beat her up and everything.
Was it a semi? Was it a semi-auto?
It was.
See,
so you, that good it was.
You talked her into giving up one. That.
I talked her into giving me everything I wanted. Mm-hmm. So I said, where's it at? She says, right over there. I said, do me a favor, stand right there.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to go retrieve it.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You had gloves on?
Full magazine, absolutely. As soon as I saw it, I said,
ooh. You gloved up.
You gloved
up? Absolutely.
You rendered it safe.
I did.
Oh, that's
how you put that be. Magnum
I
on.
I retrieved the magazine.
You put that Magnum on, huh?
Yeah, I sure did, because he was ready to go.
Absolutely.
So you know, I put it, I had my BDUs on. Put everything in my BDUs. I said, you all right? I said, just sit tight. Went in the other room. I said, what's going on, boss? You know, he's still a little hot. I said, listen, take it easy. I said, listen, she's going to fill out a form stating what happened. I said, but do me a favor, stand up. I said, you got anything on you? He said, nah, what's going on? I said, nah. And I said, listen, just calm down. I said, everything's going to be all right. I said, but I'm going to have to take you in custody. I said, you put hands on her. I said, you see her eye. I said, there's no way I can avoid not looking at that.
Mm-hmm.
I said, she didn't do it to herself, did she? Nah, but you know, I said, you're a man, right? I said, you talking to a man. So what happened? Why'd you do it? Nah, yo, I'm just tired of this shit. So, you know, I said, all right, it's okay. Mm-hmm. Turned around, put cuffs on him. got the gun, got Wait, a phenomenal case.
You ain't abuse him?
No.
You ain't beat him?
Absolutely not.
Oh, damn, man.
And you know what? He talked himself into the cuffs.
God damn.
Off of building phenomenal rapport from your boy.
Oh, and man, and you did that without a body worn camera having to say you did police work.
How about that?
Mm. 11 years of doing that, huh?
How about that?
Go figure.
Damn.
But I love how you just talked about that, how we went through it. So one of the lines I love saying is this. Anytime I see a new recruit, they go, what makes you good at this job? Verbal foreplay.
That's Wait, it. They ask you that?
All the People time. When you see a recruit, when they go, hey, well, how you get good at this job? What makes you a good
job? Yeah.
Verbal foreplay. And I say it just like that.
But they don't understand that shit takes years.
Exactly. They go, no, I'm going to be a sergeant.
Like, all of this takes time. Police work takes time. Like, yes, verbal judo takes time.
It does.
You don't just walk into a fucking dojo and be like, let me get that black belt. You got to fight for that shit. You got to learn. It's the same thing with police work.
Absolutely.
You know, it's just different, man. Because my guy, I don't want to say his name, but he was a boxer. And y'all know him. We went to his event.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's like when they get on, he's like, bro, I could be used here. I could be better used fitting this position. I could be better used in, you know, community policing. I said, no doubt. I said, but bro, you only got 3 years on.
Yeah, learn how to police.
Learn how to police.
That's all I'm asking.
You got a phenomenal resume. Mm-hmm. And what you did, which is great. I said, bro, your time is your time. You can't just demand I go to the specialized unit because I could be better served here. It's hard to get days off. I said, bro, I didn't get into the academy until I had almost 6 years on.
Mm-hmm.
And I was on patrol.
And remember, that was a phenom back then.
What?
Remember before, if you weren't in double digits, you couldn't even
apply. You couldn't even get nowhere.
But
you gotta. But it's about being patient. Your time will come.
Exactly.
You can't just demand and expect to get there because you know I got this resume. Everybody got a resume.
Absolutely.
Everybody definitely.
But
got a resume.
But that's what happens. Like they want it. I want to go here now, and then they leave. Policing's not about that.
Well, they get to a lot of times. They get to those units where they want to go, mm-hmm. yeah. and then they find out that it's not where they want. You know what I'm saying? Then yeah. they're like, oh no, I'm back.
It's
in
not
control.
All cracked up. What it's supposed to be
every time. What you want every time. Here. But I thought that's what you wanted.
Because they want to hide. They want to hide from the real world. Like, yeah. I always laugh when people go, oh, they're going to send you back to patrol. How is that a punishment?
Right. You think I care?
Oh. I'm like, what?
I get paid regardless.
Exactly. And it's easier.
Especially in patrol.
Especially in patrol. Well, a call?
Oh, my
okay.
God. Oh, you got to write a report. And?
That's easy.
15 minutes on my day.
What, give it to real life for them. Have a good night. See you later. That's it.
Oh, yeah, we going to send you. Okay, send me.
Like it's a punishment. It's easy.
Patrol? What we going to do?
Right.
You going to tell me to push a car, and as a matter of fact, you tell me to do less.
How about that?
Than I used to do.
Handling calls. You got it.
Look, matter of fact, I sit in the car and do like this. What is that new, that business check bullshit? Business check complete. Yeah. Hotspot check or
How
whatever.
How about that?
You push your computer. You don't even got to get on the radio no more.
Policing is not for everybody.
It's not. It's a career, not a job.
It really is.
Yeah, it is. I'll take the old way over this new way, though.
I think, like you said, I mean, there's benefit to it. There's what we learn from it. But I think we've gotten so far away from. My big thing is we still do police work, but we don't do law enforcement anymore. And I think that's what freaks me out the most. We don't do law enforcement. We sit here and we go through what we're doing. We go through these changes. We go through these commissioners. And we've gotten further and further away from the actual mission.
Mm.
And just to sit back and, like I said, if we could just sit back and reset and then have the opportunity to build the morale that we're missing.
Yeah.
Even if you could just get that back. Imagine if district shifts had morale again. If shifts miss working with each other again. Let's just get that back.
And I'm about to say something. I'm not taking shots or anything like that. But it's if you study books like The Art of War, and it teaches you how to command an army, one of the most important rules of winning a war or slash battle is your soldiers have to be happy. You
Absolutely.
Have to take care of your soldiers.
Absolutely.
Not your shoulders, but your soldiers.
Yeah.
And the funny part is I always laugh because in the army especially, they have more NWR days, mandatory fun. It's military wellness and relaxation. It's literally mandatory unit fun. Mm. It's a fun set aside where your unit commander has to do something with the unit together. So it's mandatory fun. Mm. And it's done after every major training event. It's done at least every 6 months during most deployments. It's mandatory fun.
Yeah.
Just to force you to interact with each other.
Right.
Because no matter what, military, police work, academy, even college, for any sport we've played, any team sport, after about 2 months of being around a motherfucker, you just don't want to be named no more.
Right.
We all remember about 6, 7, 8 months in the academy during our time.
Absolutely. Yeah, like you fall into your certain cliques, yep. You know what I'm saying? And that mandatory fun.
Breaks
now,
that click.
Right, it breaks the click. Now you have to be forced to interact with like somebody that's there, yeah. But you don't really necessarily fuck
with. Yeah, you go, I don't really fuck with.
But then you end
you,
up meeting this person.
You ain't
you're
so
like,
bad.
Right. I feel like if you everybody says it, like if you wanna win a war, your team gotta be happy. If they was to take care of the team the right way, the way that we should, I mean, like, was one of the most violent cities, like inflation is through the roof. Like you could go to Target and get paid $15 an hour. So like,
yeah.
Like, you got to take care of your soldiers. Like, so they could go out there. There's no distractions. They could go out there, do the job, and give you the best results.
Yeah.
So that the public gets the best results.
Agreed.
You don't want to go out there and some guy's worrying about, you know, money issues because yeah. He's distracted.
Did my time get blocked in a certain application that we use? Or my hours on my check?
How about that?
Do I need to pay the city back money?
Yeah, like if you take care of the troops, man, they will go out there and fight.
Yeah, two guys for you.
Think about every great supervisor you'll die for.
Yep.
It's okay. You.
Absolutely.
Oh, why'd you want to become a supervisor?
I was lucky enough that I had good and bad supervisors. So I was lucky enough when I came on, KJ
everybody says
was
that.
My first drug sergeant.
Mm.
So he showed me the epitome of being a sergeant. He showed me the epitome of being a supervisor. Then right after him, I had she's retired now, a fantastic drug cop who used to actually be up in the Northern. Female, amazing. When I say she showed me how you build an actual post book.
Mm.
How do you do an identifiable book when you do an ID book of everybody that sells? Every
a
time
post
you've been
book.
A
wow.
legitimate one. You know what I'm talking about, where you got the addresses, who they related
name,
to.
Name, faces, everything.
Their brother, their cousin,
right.
Their sister,
mama.
Who their mama.
Everything.
Even got the number on the back of the page.
Facts.
Down to your major businesses where they hang out at, who right. The owner of the business. So that was that first understanding of that. So I walked in the door with that. Then I flip side, I had some horrible sergeants. And one of the things I'm like, I can do that better. And my whole point was, when we talk about morale, my biggest point was this. So I'm a proponent of morale and training. I'm a huge proponent of training.
I love training.
The facts of the matter, y'all know we don't get enough. So I was a guy, I was like, how do I get somebody else trained the way I got trained? How do I give them that opportunity? Because I can't give it all to them, because I only get them now. I was in times adjusted. So the minute I got promoted, I pushed the additional training that I went through to other people. Even if I had to pay or take them to the training.
Mm.
It was just taking that to that extra step. Because to me, that's what a supervisor was supposed to do. So now we're at that point where you go, so why I want to take the next step? Same thing. It's like you can affect a squad. But then you go, all right, well, I'm trying to get these person days for training to this. Or I'm trying to get this person more involved in this. But they can't get a day off because we ain't got enough bodies.
Mm.
Or the sergeant, my partner sergeant may not be a hard charger like I am. Or may not have that same goal for their people like I am. And if I take over their people, they're going to have an issue. So who affects patrol better than the white shirt? And we all know there's only one that affects them better.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my push for the next level. And then the jealous one-sided side, I got sick of all these goddamn people giving me orders and bossing me around. So
I feel you.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Seems certain people only respect you if you wear a certain color shirt in this agency sometimes. So you got to move like that. But honestly, I had that balance of good supervisors where I was like, I wanted to emulate them. And I had bad ones where I wanted to be better than them. So that's what pushed me further. What makes me hang on, I think honestly, is the same thing. Sitting back going, can it be done right? Can it be done in another method or another way, even in the environment we are now? Can I make my shift better if I'm in patrol? if I'm in CID, can I make my shift better, my squad better, or my unit better? And how do I do that? And we go back to, like you said, it's morale. It's going back to the basics of putting the officer before me, yeah, putting the sergeant before me.
I love, everybody always asks me, you know, when you're taking the test, stop bullshitting. And I get it. I think I'm a phenomenal leader, just me being me.
True.
And talking to people and, you know, just giving them game and gems to this profession. Will I do it one day? You know what? I don't know.
You going to.
I will at some point.
I'm going to put the pressure on you.
I know you are.
We got to set up a cabal coming soon.
Lord. But what make me do it is the soft supervisors. That are not alphas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's the conversation I think all three of us that had repeatedly.
That, but yeah, just seeing them and I'm like, really? They promoted this motherfucker?
You kidding me? Matter of fact, I got one for you because we've been throwing it out a couple times. We keep talking about an alpha. Have we ever actually explained to your listeners what an alpha really is?
Explain to them.
Because I think a lot of times people misconstrue that alpha as aggression or overly aggressive.
I feel like people, especially nowadays, they have different meanings for alpha.
Absolutely. Yeah.
People have like, you know, took it in and made it to them. And it's
yeah.
Like,
they critiqued it to them. To
their like, stop it.
To their standards.
It. So right. I think to simplify, for me, the simplified version of alpha is this. There's an aura of a certain way. And an alpha can be a male or female.
Absolutely.
But there's an aura.
Female alpha.
You I love a female my, alpha. No,
there's nothing better.
Tell me to shut the fuck up.
Yeah,
yes,
absolutely.
Ma'am. Woo.
Yes, ma'am.
Absolutely.
This city has way more alpha females.
Facts.
It's a Baltimore thing.
There's way more alpha females than there is alpha males.
But one of the big things I think when we describe an alpha is that person with that aura.
I'm just saying.
You talking about an agency, not the city.
Right. I'm talking about the city, the agency, shit.
But yeah. that definition is defined as that person that has that aura, that presence. Not only that presence of body and person, but that presence of leadership.
Confidence.
And it's natural.
Absolutely.
It's not forced.
There's no faking.
Exactly. There's no falsehood to it.
Right.
And they speak truth.
Right.
They have no problem being honest and direct with you.
Right.
We're not saying ignorant or aggressive. We're saying they literally speak truth.
Right.
And what people don't comprehend, they'll give a person a title alpha because of their position, not because of their presence.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Not because of their understanding.
The position does not make you alpha.
Absolutely. You can walk to a scene and automatically identify the person on the scene. You go, he may be the primary, but I'm going to holler at him.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to holler at her. Because that's where I'm going to get the information. How many times you done come up on the scene and done it? How many times you done it as a leader when you sat there and you used to go through those academy classes?
Absolutely.
You go through the class and go, them right there.
Yeah.
We going to make these weak people like
they
leaders.
They get it. They get it.
But they the ones that's going to carry the class.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's a lot of times where we get misconstrued because everybody like to throw that title on that line and don't even know what it mean. You know, if he's an alpha cop, he overly aggressive, he beat on people. I've never had an excessive force complaint.
Me neither.
I mean, yeah.
But mind you, we didn't all been in scraps.
Absolutely.
And more than a few. But we always knew when to stop.
Yeah.
Like I talked about when you asked me earlier, my childhood, I had a horrible temper growing up. I didn't become a cop because I was a punk. I didn't become a cop because I couldn't fight. I didn't become a cop because I wasn't in sports. We know for a fact. You was never the cat that wasn't in sports. Same with you. None of us became a cop because we were weak. We literally took this job in this career. And I clarified it too, because this career is what we are. Yeah. Deep down, it's literally what we are. It's what we do.
Sheep
in every aspect of it. Exactly. Every aspect of what we do is what we are.
Yeah.
And that's how we carry it.
Yeah. It's true.
Now we do. We natural protectors.
Absolutely.
Natural protectors.
I honestly took this job because I don't like bullies.
Me too.
You know, I can't see an old lady getting robbed. That
absolutely
shit drives
not
me nuts.
But, yeah. Or people just if beating on somebody.
Yeah, just to do it.
Just praying on the weak.
15 dudes jumping one guy.
Like,
absolutely
really?
Stop not. It.
And they think that shit is cool. Like,
that
that's
shit
what's
is
up.
The corniest shit.
None
ever.
Of y'all got a knuckle game.
But quick to get
a gun.
Fight them one D.
Or a knife.
Fight them one D.
Shoot the fair one.
Yeah.
Fight
them one D.
Shoot the fair one. Get some gloves.
But they ain't built like that.
They
no
ain't
more.
Built like that.
And they damn sure ain't built like that now.
What?
No, they definitely.
Motherfuckers quickly pull a gun out.
It's easier than them. Everything is the easiest method now.
They killed my man, Young Dolph, man.
And I can't even call him pussy because that would be disrespectful to something I love.
I know, I love her. But
But nah, I mean, that was the whole thing when I looked at it. And I think when we look at our leaders, that's our failure now. We don't have enough alphas anymore in the leadership.
Yo, I saw, did you see the email of the one that's retiring March 1st?
Yeah.
Dropped the bomb.
Yo, he killed it. He said, this leadership doesn't exist anymore.
Did you see?
Laid it. He said, laid it. And it would never be duplicated.
Dropped the bomb.
Dropped the bomb.
And then he named.
Yes, the true leaders.
And then like,
oh,
they,
oh, yeah. Shit.
With nicknames.
Looking at the email.
Yeah, I got to read all the emails.
Like, oh, he was like, yo, dot, 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 the professor, dot, dot, dot.
Right. The whiz like kid.
The yeah. Intel.
Right.
Dot, dot, dot.
Oh.
He said, the these mentor. Are the true leaders.
Oh,
and
shit.
It doesn't exist anymore.
It was like,
you know,
it was like 12 of them. He named like 12.
Facts.
Of them.
See? And that's what I'm saying. Look, when have we ever had that type of level? Just
he literally on paper dropped the mic and walked away.
And walked away.
You see what I'm saying? Like, and I heard it's a gang leaving in March.
They all out.
You heard, right?
It's a gang. So there's a problem, right? If these few leaders that are like we consider are leaving, now it's on us.
But here's the problem. We abrasive. I just told you my label, fam. And you literally know me how long?
Yeah, since it came on.
So how do we fix this?
Our voice got to speak louder than theirs.
Because there's a lot of experience walking out this door.
Agreed.
There's a lot of like, hey, how do I go about this case?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
You know, there's a lot of that goes on like, hey.
Our voice have to speak.
Like Big Bro Deez. Yo, yes. I get into a box. I get into a situation where, when you lead into an investigation, you hit all your ends. And you're like, fuck, like what? Like, does this guy really? I call him. And I'm like, and he's like, did you do this? But did you do that? But look at this again. And I'm like, oh, shit.
Yeah, you're right. We lost the great one out the
Once
Southeast.
We don't have that.
We lost the great one out the Southwest. I'm sorry, not Southwest, not the Southeast. You know who I'm at my left. He gone. Then you talk about, like I say, JB talking, and the Homicide talking about Roland. Sit here and tell me there's a better cat in the box. That's where we at right now. Like I said, then you got other leaders calling people out as they walk out the door. And you sit here and tell me we're not burning right now? We're not desperate for leaders?
What?
Can we stop being petty? Like, let's just, like, if he's nicer than you at that, like, just accept it and you be nice at what you're doing. That's it.
You got to be an alpha to accept that, though.
Then he's not whoever that is not an alpha.
You know it as well as I do. They're not taking it.
Oh,
what was that?
Feel better?
Where did that?
Did you fart?
And that's why I was like, who did that?
I can't wait till we try to cut that one out.
Is there like a person? I thought it came from over there. Yo.
Oh, man. Too much fun.
So one of the other things I get, what do y'all think about the family aspect the way we are? Do we even have a family anymore? Is it truly a BPD family left?
Yo, he asking us questions. That's
and
dope.
And gentlemen, you mean for the department?
I'm asking, I know we have that small unity that's still floating there.
As a department, a whole hell no, because everybody's selfish. Everybody has their why of why they're doing this. I don't think, it's not a family.
Then how do we survive?
I don't know. Stay under the radar.
They won, bro. Divide and conquer.
It's not surviving, but...
Bro, they won.
Mm-hmm.
Divide and conquer.
And that's what they've been doing.
We have been divided.
Yep. Now the question is, are we going to let them conquer us? Think about it. We're literally at the precipice right now. Look at how they're promoting and what they're promoting. You already know, we all know in this room, we can probably name three of the next generation of captains they're about to promote.
Yeah.
I don't.
And out of that three... He's like, what the fuck?
Hey, yo, honestly, it's so bad. Like, I love police work, but when I go back, I don't know.
It's exhausting.
I'm just going to sit there and be positive. That's all.
That's a great date, but I get it.
Though. You see what I'm saying?
Like, I ain't got coming up. But that's absolutely right.
I'm both serious.
Yeah, I feel you.
Dude got shot 20 times. I bless you, bro.
Yo.
Yeah, like,
no speedy recovery.
I mean, I always do that. I pray for you, but if you don't tell me who the shooter is, then there's nothing for us to talk about, papi. I'm here to find out who's your shooter.
I don't know.
You don't tell me. I got nothing.
I love policing. I love it.
Agreed.
You know? Yeah, honestly, I think I realized with this little, you know, thing that I've been going through, I don't think it's more so because they ruined the game. Whoever, I'm not blaming nobody. Yeah. Like, I'm not going to sit here and be like, argh. But what I am going to say is, I miss the like my people, like the police jokes, the police, like us, like the humor, the humor of us. Because
I rapport with each other,
the family,
yeah,
the family. That's the family.
Because I experience, you know, different, mm-hmm. and it's a little different. Not bad, but it's not this.
It's not home. Yeah,
this is this. Like, you know, you could go out with your guys and, you know, really go ham, and you know you good and. But it's the actual, like, the job. I mean,
you know, that shit. It came true when everybody was saying Corey Reggie. They said, "Yo, y'all got a squad, mm-hmm. and y'all gel so well, y'all click." They said, "Yo, it's not gonna last long."
Nope.
They attack. I said, "Why?" He said, "Cause they're gonna see how well you guys are together, and they're gonna break that shit up."
But my question is, why?
Because it's hate.
That's the problem.
It's the end of hate with the higher ranks that we can't do nothing.
But you got a group of people that are working together. Let's say you run eight people.
Yep.
You got eight people in your squad, six people.
Yeah.
And they all get along. Why would you split the three?
I wouldn't. But you're looking who you're interacting with, who you asking.
Right.
Now, take me as a dude that I got this after 3 years. I ain't cut my bones doing nothing. I'm 3 years sergeant, fresh out the gate. I come in. It's been so OIC for the past 7 months, handling, rocking. I come in. You hand me a book. Hey, this is what you need to do. Da da da, sergeant. We good. All we need to do, sir. Da da da. We lined up everything for you. Here's the vacation book. We already did it in order, sir. Anything additional you need? Because you that tight with your squad. And this is happening in Northeast Sector 1. You know it has. Mm-hmm. You remember that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about, right? Mm-hmm. When they separated and sent me to the midnight shift. Mm-hmm. Remember? Mm-hmm. Handed it. Laid out. Know what I was told? It's my motherfucking squad. Mm. I'll do what I want. Been there a hot 45 minutes. New sergeant. I ain't come disrespectful. I literally was lining it up like, hey, we gravy. This the postcards. If you want to make any adjustment, here's a by number. Am I lying? Huh? But you have people that are so small-minded that they feel as though if I piss you off or I manipulate you or use you, I control you. It's not about control. It's about success. The mission's success. Prime example. Remember they used to do that bullshit? Your first, 3 or 4 months in the Northeast, mm-hmm. you would get your post either Sector 1, Sector 2, or Sector 3. You rock and ride with your post. Once you get and you knew what side of the park you was on, that was your shit. Mm-hmm. Right or wrong? Mm-hmm. Once you had your shit, you knew you was gravy. How many times y'all done seen a motherfucker walk in and come at D like that? How long D been there? Forever. D broke me in on the Northeast.
Yeah. He breaks majors in.
Thank you. So who are you to take D off his post?
Yeah.
But has it been done? You see what I'm saying? People have control issues because they're not confident in themselves.
At all.
Like one of the things that kills me. You know, we're one of the largest agencies in the state. Used to be the largest, but we like teeter line now. You know, our supervisor school is a week long. The school police even send their motherfucking sergeants to a 2-week school. Mm. In Sykesville. How the largest agency in the state spend 5 days to teach you how to be a sergeant? Explain that to me.
I can't tell you.
How you got people that are sergeant that's never been FTOs? Run that game.
Yeah.
You won't come to a multi-year vet with 3 years on and you never trained one body. Why is that not an automatic requirement in our agency? Go to any other agency, it's a requirement. We have lowered our standards so much here and accepted it because we've allowed weak people to lead us.
Mm.
The email you just identified demonstrated that. Mm-hmm. We have weak leaders that don't want you to put, you have to have X amount of time in patrol. You got to be an FTO. You got to spend this amount of time.
Do you think 5 years in patrol is too long?
No, hell no. 5 years in patrol is right where you should be.
100%.
You shouldn't even take the test till you get the 5 years.
100%.
2 years in, you just learning your flavor. That's when you put in for FTO. Then you spend a year and a half to 2 years to train. Boom. Now you confident. Then you get that last year OIC. Now you understand how to supervise. You learned on trainees. You got at least 2 years. That's a minimum of four trainees.
I like the way you broke that down. I like the way you broke that down. You spent 5 years learning how to become a sergeant.
How do you not learn this position? That's how you learn. One, when we used to come on member, we only did one or two calls, cars. Unless you was a, unless you was the floater, you literally worked 13, 15, or 11 when you came in. Mm-hmm. You was always 13 or 15. So you knew the side of the park you was going to be on. Mm-hmm. You feel me? Once you left ops, you came back, you had to relearn everything, right or wrong. It's not to be smart. I ain't saying you wasn't good at ops, but see and tell me how much better you would have been if you would have spent 2 years in patrol first. How much more stuff would you have identified?
Oh, no. I went to...
out the gate, right?
No. We started on foot, but then when I got to the Northeast, I did 5 years there, and then after the riots,
yeah, okay,
things opened up.
No, I mean, you did VSIP before you got Northeast, right?
No, it was after.
Okay, that was after.
Yeah,
okay.
After, yeah.
Okay, but yeah, you see what I mean? Did that not give you a different eye? No, that's what I'm saying.
Like, I agree. You have to do the 5 years.
Yeah, it gives you a completely different eye and understanding.
Absolutely.
And we talked earlier that verbal foreplay.
Yeah,
you learn that by interacting. If you ain't answering calls, you don't know how to be police.
You don't.
I got kicked back to patrol for, it wasn't for like that. It was for
dumb shit.
Dealing with bitch ass sergeants.
Don't worry, I've been there. He'll tell you. I've been there, right or wrong.
Just one bitch ass sergeant. I always talk about bitch.
Yeah, I still want to make this. I gotta go shake this man's hand. I'm like, dog, you the most famous asshole I know.
He's the most famous bitch you will always hear about.
Bitch. But nah, so Triple C, as the guy that had to take all our warrants, what's your opinion, brother? Are we over here just whining?
No. From
that was good stuff.
From not only being a commissioner, but like I said, from I tell them my godmother was an OG. She's probably, I think she was the fifth black police detective in Baltimore City.
Came from Ohio. Beautiful.
So she knows, like, all the old school commissioners, the one that was on. She knows she loved them, blah, blah, blah. But one of the things that she said was the same thing like you saying. And I love that from, being on the federal side, especially working down at Meade.
Mm-hmm.
You can't make sergeant till a certain amount of years. And they'll tell you, you have to have a certain amount of training, a certain amount of this. Same thing as you move up. Even on the civilian side, you can't look. Like, they may say the job is open for you to be promoted after a year, mm-hmm. but you gotta have, like, you better have worked with a president and been overseas, been damn near as a civilian, been in BDUs, combat, exactly. This, that, and forth, and came back. They like, yeah, this person's sharp, because it's just not gonna happen for you. So, for a lot of people, when you all were saying training, people really gotta look at that, you know what I'm saying? And just not only police officers, but civilians, everybody else has to look at that and really say, what does that mean? And I think, I know we'll get back around to it, but it has to be that it's sad to say, but everybody's at a breaking point, meaning these cities are losing money, even with pandemic and everything else. People, like during the summertime, they lost millions upon millions upon millions of dollars because nobody's going downtown to get shot. Mm-hmm. They're just not. So if I'm gonna keep my money in the county or wherever else where it's safer for me, they're losing money, and it ain't just because of the pandemic; it's because of safety. So it's gonna flip, but I think you all got hit all at once. Like, again, us being in and around our 40s or in our 40s, I've never seen like major events. So like when the Rodney King thing happened, we were young. But that didn't affect Baltimore City.
Agreed.
You see what I'm saying? And that was the first time that any of us has seen anything like, I mean, we have seen it with five. I'm talking about on TV, national TV. That was the first time that we've seen something like that. That didn't affect Baltimore City Police Department. That didn't affect New York City, blah, 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 the standing for. So something else happens and then triggers everybody else to say, we got to take a look at everybody. Those are things that is just new for everything that's going on, coupled with social media. You know what I'm saying? Now everybody's an amateur videographer. Mm-hmm. So now it's like they won't have the part where they calling y'all a bunch of bitches, a bunch of da 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 da. But then it starts as soon as they hit that one thing where they may say something to you. You know what I'm saying? So I hope people understand it was sort of like everybody was going in on LeBron. about that incident, but nobody understood what those people said. And I immediately thought, damn, that could have been y'all. Mm-hmm. Those people were heckling him the entire game. And then the one thing that pushed him was they said, yo, I hope your son die.
Mm. Wow.
Absolutely.
So what? So that dude is he. And again, he's a millionaire, billionaire, but he's still from the hood. Yep. But then he has something had to catch him to say, I could lose everything for swinging on one of these people. Yo, get him out of here. Y'all don't have that luxury to say, yo, get him out of here, because y'all the people that got to get him out of here. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? And then that's when the camera starts. So the camera starts when that they didn't threaten y'all and said that one thing, boom. Now they like, I'm trying to go get my millions. So somewhere we have to, I love what you said about the military. Like, we got to be, like, I guess, vigilant. We got to be quick. We got to slow down. We got to slow down. You know, like, that's one of the things that throughout the going on our 3 years, that's the one thing y'all been saying. Yo, slow down. Do not just, yo, just because you see it on TV, slow down. This job, I know you're going to be that.
This job is not for hotheads.
It's not.
At all. And you'll become a liability.
And as a hothead, I applaud that statement, because that's one of the greatest things I think I learned about why I love this career.
Yeah.
It made me learn balance.
Yeah.
It made me fight through frustration. Like, I'm literally the one. I learned now, instead of yelling and screaming, I just get quiet.
Kill him with kindness.
Absolutely. Well, no, I'm not as gifted as you. I just get quiet.
You still got
it. And I start mugging shit out of him. I can't kill him with quiet. You got that sweet, you got that silver tongue. You start spitting that sweet shit. I'm
phenomenal with that verbal warfare.
Yeah, you come with motherfuckers, they be like, okay.
Yeah.
I'd be like, look, I'm going to take off my gun and beat the shit out of you real quick. We're going to keep it up. But actually, I'm a lot more calmer now, I promise.
But even the public, women, children, and cops, nobody was going up. Everybody knew that was, like, the people that we grew up around knew it was bad for business.
Yes.
And that's literally what it was, bad for business. So I'm not, you shut down all of this. I'm losing money, millions of dollars. I'm not, so we're going to have conversations. We might go back and forth laughing, but no, nobody. So it's weird for me. I don't know how y'all do it every day. I tell you, I tell them that all the time. I don't know how y'all do it.
I think it's a calling, in my honest opinion. Yeah, and I think y'all said it before. I think it's a legitimate calling. And you identify real police. And I think real police identify other real police.
Absolutely.
But I think we're all at the point where we're tired.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the best way I can say it.
Enough is enough. Like, I get it. If shit was cute, we did what we did. Yeah. Everybody did what they did across the country. I got it. Now it's time. All right. Look, it's not working.
Yeah.
Like what you just said, like, where as a society did we say, or did it become cool to be like, hey, LeBron, you suck. Fuck your kids. I hope they die. Like, are we really at that point?
That,
like,
level of disrespect.
Oh, you fucking cops. I hope you're fucking, I hope you, you know, like, and it's like, dog, because of my profession, you wish, but if I do it to you, you run on camera.
You want
to
go get a lawsuit.
That's right.
You go get a lawyer.
They be all of it. They be like, everybody knows it should be hands length apart. They be right there in y'all face. Like, bro, it's COVID and I got to go home. Like, that's why I tell you, I don't know how y'all do it.
Half the time, we're not even worried about that shit.
Yeah. Like I said, the sacrifice, the risk. Like when you sat back, how many times you just sat back and just sat down with your cup? And when, how many birthdays you'd have missed? Plays, concerts, teacher conference.
Yeah, like I miss birthdays to go deal with this, whereas, you know, I'm the people that want me there.
Yeah.
That won't curse at me. I'm not.
I'm dissing them. I'm dissing the person that want me, the one that hold me to be here with you.
For the people that want to curse you out.
Yeah.
I mean, we do that. That's what we do.
Like, how do I look like to my family right now? What did I just give up for you? One of the things I hate, I'm sorry, I got to jump back on the leaders thing. Have you noticed now in this new trend over the past couple years where your major and your captain are off on Thanksgiving and Christmas?
I ain't know that.
Have you seen that shit running in districts? Still, how often you see your major on the major holidays?
I see him. I mean, I haven't.
But you had H, right?
The last time I was there. He was there.
But you had one of the old head ones.
Yeah.
You get what I'm saying? These young cats, you can't even find them. Mm. I'm supposed to be, I'm with my family. Bro, so we. Right. Where you at?
So that's what I'm saying. So like, how am I supposed to follow you into battle?
You get what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? You fat. You your belly full
you
of turkey.
You forgot to sacrifice.
Fam, I
didn't
even bring
you a plate. Absolutely.
I mean, you know, supermarket sushi. And you talking about, yeah, you know, I'm with my family. What happened? What you mean? The fuck you? Like,
I love the story when I think H, your partner, said he came when he was young, and Norris was on it, and he was like one. He was like, who is one? He was like, no, get him, lock him up. He was like, oh shit, he in the streets with us. He
oh,
was like,
Derek,
he was out here running around like locking Derek, people up. Like,
yeah, Norris was a that's a true knucklehead right there.
He about that business.
Yeah,
he was zero tolerance.
All we needed was that man to get a pardon.
What?
But
zero tolerance.
But that's that old school police mindset. Yeah. And I'm not saying that it's gone. I think politics has scared it out of the people that's moving up.
I just don't understand why politics is in everything now. It's in everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You go to a supermarket and they're like, well, you know, you should have because.
I just think they.
What?
Just don't listen to the white noise all the time.
I just like to be left alone.
Man. Absolutely. That's what I mean to do my job.
10% of the population going to complain on both sides. Yeah. Just so what?
But all just let me do my job.
Yeah. It seems like everyone's crying.
Yeah.
Yes.
And they listen to the small pieces.
But it's not a lot of crybabies. It's literally like he said, 20%.
Small pieces.
Yes. Can't each in.
But they make the most noise.
Absolutely. But think about it. We cry all day. Notice we never speak out.
Yeah.
We'll take the worst all day. But then the dude that don't do nothing is the one that's whining about, oh, I couldn't get off, so I'm going to be sick. We grinding talking about sick. Bro, I'm going to take my little 8 VMIs. But I ain't never sick.
Kidding me? I can't remember shit.
Exactly.
I can't remember ever taking a medical day.
Exactly.
It's never been heard of.
Fam, people make fun of you if you ever took a medical day.
Yeah, look at it now.
You probably got dudes come back
with
to
a year and a half on.
You'd be like, what?
With no medical time.
Facts. Yeah.
What have you ever seen
that? That's unheard of.
It's like, what were you doing?
Oh, they wouldn't give me the day off, so I'm sick.
What? I'm putting that.
Huh? Day off.
And what did you do?
Remember how many P days you used to lose?
Wow. Yo,
you had to go to your sergeant and your payroll clerk like, I miss P5.
Hey, yo, I used to love that shit. I missed P5 of 18. Well, I'm using that bitch in 19.
We good, right?
We good, right?
Isabel.
Right,
sorry.
Right.
I'm sorry.
She was the best.
I love her, guys. I said her name. I'm sorry.
I love
Kill
her.
Kill me later, Miss Isabel.
It's all good. Woo. She made it work, though.
Did she?
What?
Oh, yeah, she did. She did.
I'm talking about we. I remember one year, I think I missed like 7 PDs.
Word. But she made it work.
She's like, I got you. Don't even worry about it.
Word.
Didn't he take them? Didn't he know? Oh, I love this one. Remember? I didn't know what a vacation book was 4 years in. Never seen it.
That's what I'm saying. Like my first 3 years, days off, huh?
They was like vacation book.
Your regular age days.
It was literally, I remember the senior man would go, you know, we got a vacation book, but you ain't getting it.
Yeah.
So we good. Like, huh? But what is it? Don't even worry about it, bro.
Yo,
you good.
When I first, it was like 15 motherfuckers in my squad. I was the last one.
You remember that?
I think I had like a day. Listen. It's all good though, cause I bagged all my
like
shit.
January,
right?
Right. That's next, your shit.
Right. The first week of January, you can get your shit off.
Yeah,
that's it. Other
that's
than
how
that,
it was though. 3 years
that's
in.
That's how it was.
I think that's the first time I saw the vacation.
Yeah, it was right. 3 years in,
and I think I got 2 days.
Yeah,
approved. And I was back happy to back, officially fuck. Back to back. Cause we talk about not like sporadic days, like back to back days.
Yeah. Hey yo, if your senior guys or dudes that was ahead of you on the senior list. Your squad,
oh, they would tell you. They tell you they crushing it,
and they're like, "Yo, I got all the motherfucking December off.
Yep.
I got all the July off.
They tell you
back. I
work in July, book.
Right? Yeah, they tell you, like, yo, I busted that all in this one.
Yeah, all up in
good luck trying to get a day. And I'm like, thanks, nice, appreciate it.
Book, yo, you look at the days,
look at the book,
like, yo, who the fuck?
Look,
the book, this thick, the leaf slips, that thick.
Word. And your supervisor just sit there like, I do that for you, bro. See if you can switch with somebody else.
Look,
with
another unit. Look,
random days.
Such and such said, on your birthday, he'll give you the day after.
Oh, your birthday.
But you got to work the next weekend.
Absolutely.
You be sitting there looking at the most awkward days, like, who the fuck?
Who the fuck will get this day off?
Who takes February the 11th and the 12th?
Word. Like, what are you doing?
I can't even get Valentine's Day. Nah, you having that shit on the 10th. Right.
Word. Yeah, your Valentine's Day this year is on the 8th.
Yo, but you know the funny part?
Go have dinner.
We love that shit.
We had fun.
That shit was fun. You
be like this. All right, Ben, let's go do it.
We good. Let's grind.
But you know it's cool because that I shit, added all those days.
Yep. And that same
and we got to keep those P days that we lost. We get to get those extra vacation days.
You bank them.
You bank them.
And now we sitting there taking 2 weeks off and shit.
Facts. Right. You get like 2-3 years on top of that. Then, then you're the senior guy.
Oh, yep. Oh, gosh, yeah. But it was that education.
I remember there was this one tool, was this one dude. I don't even remember his name. He may not even be around. But I remember it was like April. He didn't have no days off. And I'm like, what did you do? He's like, yeah, I was just calling out. And I'm like, why?
Yeah.
Like, you're done, you dummy. Like, oh, I need a time off. Yeah, so you blew your load that early in the year?
Really?
Like, you know, it's only April, right?
Like, bro.
You know, like, we're going into the summer.
Yeah, you ain't hit June yet, bro.
No.
When you really need a day.
Where you
but
going?
You know what? He never worked the real 6-2.
Yeah, 6-2. Yeah, it was crazy.
He ain't know about that.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'm a little nosy, but my thing is, like, if you take a day off, like, what are you doing?
Home? Not a motherfucking thing.
I can't take a day off and be home.
Neither can I. It ain't no point.
If I'm going to take a day off, it's like...
Yeah, if I'm going to burn a day, I got to do something.
Now, my H days of my H days
will be home. Yeah, we talking about burning a day. If I'm like going to burn a day, I got to do something.
If I'm burning a day, valuable. I'm getting my feet done.
I'm doing something,
my hair cut. I'm going to go smoke a cigar.
I'm doing something.
I'm relaxed.
Decompressing.
Yeah, but that's like once in a while for you.
It's male grooming for me.
Yeah, but you don't do it all the time, though.
No, because it's grind. Not here to work.
That's probably like you. That's like your spa day.
Absolutely.
And that's what I'm saying. But you're entitled to
that. That's Papi H's day.
I'm talking about you taking off on a random Tuesday for no reason.
And it never happened.
That's a waste of time and effort.
Absolutely.
Like you right now calling out tomorrow.
And it never happened.
For no reason.
That motherfucker couldn't even remember the number.
Exactly.
To play PlayStation. I'm like, you.
I don't do that.
I'd be like, what's a play? What is that? I thought PlayStations didn't even exist anymore.
Yeah, it only like, yeah.
Those just exist.
Everybody different, bro.
Yeah.
Like, wow.
Everybody different.
We like you said, we a different breed.
38 and you still on the Xbox?
Yeah. Like that primary. Like I play with a box, but it ain't an Xbox.
They be like, yo, Dre, you be on.
I'm like, sorry. Like I got different focuses.
Yeah, this exactly.
But you know, also right. to those that used, I could see how a lot of people use that. Like I know people that are beast on like the games,
mm-hmm.
but they don't burn a day for that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about the guy that burns a day specifically.
Listen,
to like go to a tournament.
It's your days, motherfucker. Use them how you see fit.
Yeah, that's true.
I just know at the end of the day, you know, it's
you
all about
that shit in the end.
It's all about you know preparing yourself.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So when you can retire, you could do what you want to do.
Right.
That's
the main thing.
I look at that three, that four, that five, that 3.5 year grind that we did when I came when I did that 3.5 year grind when I really didn't take no time off. Now I banked enough time.
Yeah,
I think I take like if I went on vacation, like I literally go away on my birthday for a week now.
Yeah,
I remember early on never did no shit like that. Like one of the big things I think I'm blessed to figure out, and you figured it out years ago, and I never paid no mind to it. I remember we used to laugh and joke when you were still at the academy about how you knew how to just step away and take care of yourself. Remember, I was always on this shit, always mm-hmm. answering my phone. I was one of them cats for the longest, man. 2021 really woke me up because of COVID and all that shit that we did with COVID. It made me step back and assess myself, and I tell everybody, and what I've learned to tell everybody is this, and I used to be one of the people that just ignore it. Mental health actually matters.
Hell
taking
yeah.
the time to separate yourself from this matters. And I was literally one of those cats that never knew how to do that.
Yeah.
I was thankful to be around a group of people or be around select people that actually held that in my head over the past year and a half. And I'm so appreciative of that. My boy, all jokes, SR, who's in the Central, was a major contributor back in 2020. You was a major contributor talking to it before you went over the way you at.
Mm-hmm.
I honestly, truly comprehend how important that shit was. Because I never comprehended that I just didn't step back. I just didn't hang the phone up. Yeah. You literally have to be, like, you got to be selfish.
You got to be.
And like I said, I'm truly thankful for that. But like I said, I applaud my man, SR. Like I said, if he was on here, I would say his name fully. But mm-hmm. if he know he in the Central, he know who he is. And he was the one that amplified that for me, really, when I was going through a really fucked up time.
Yeah.
And that opened my eyes that taking care of yourself, it matters, and it matters to a different level.
Absolutely.
Especially in this career. And contrary to all the belief out there for all the cops that listen, admin is worse than patrol. Don't believe the hype. That is easier. Trust me. H can tell the bullshit I go through on a daily basis. When I tell you, yo, good God.
I remember being hurt and lying.
Yes.
So I don't be at 99 doing that.
Yes.
What?
Do you remember that shit? Admin? The dogs, the desk?
I would never be
Never.
I'm in overtime. I would.
Yeah. I'm talking about
overtime.
Yeah.
Overtime, I'll mean, be at that front desk answering calls like it's
no. But on my motherfucking shift? Hell no. What? That shit was disrespect. What?
The squad out working
you
like,
you sitting here fucking eating Luna Dooms and shit?
Nah.
Eating fucking dipping cookies and milk.
That's a motherfucking violation. Your squad looking at you like, yo, you good? Nah, fuck that. I'm coming out like this.
Milking injuries and shit.
Like I said, I remember, you know, what they start that safe shit? Like 2019 or some shit?
Yeah, honestly, right now, police work is a blur to me, so don't ask me.
Yeah, what is that? That
shit just started.
Hey, I ain't mad at you.
I don't know nothing.
I'm just...
But these cats, when they burn through leave, it just kills me. It's like that camaraderie, that brotherhood is gone.
It's over a lot of things.
And until we reset, we're in a spiral. And like you said, you got one commander to do it. Guess what? You know another one going to do it.
Yeah.
And what do we do?
I don't know. We just got to, you know, keep building, keep touching the people that we touch in a positive way. Keep...
So go back to the academy, start playing.
Yo, shout out to everybody that puts the uniform on.
Absolutely.
In all these cities. Philly, our heart goes out to you. NYPD is just, yo, every city right now.
Every department.
Everybody getting hit.
It's not a good look.
It's bad when you got the county getting hit the way they are here.
Facts.
Texas. If you put on that uniform, man, our heart goes out to y'all because it's rough. It is
police,
rough.
Fire. Everybody, all first line responders, be safe. Sarge, what you got? What shout out you got, man?
My biggest shout out is this, like you stated. I want to shout out, as always, to the first responders across the country. Let it be nurses, fire, police. Let it be the doctors, especially our most important doctor that come in when we need them.
You already know.
Shout out to that man every day. More than earned the respect to every uniform.
May God bless you and your family.
All day, every day. But I get truly
hit up, any hospital I want to go to, shock trauma. Send me downtown.
But I want to truly give a shout out, and I ask the voice of the people that understand what first responders go through, the voice of the people that understand what law enforcement go through. Y'all voice need to be heard, and y'all need to speak in that reference. Let them hear you like they hear the negativity, because that at this point is what we need. Wake up and be aware. Let them know that you understand that we are needed. Because it's clearly been forgotten.
Well said. Dre.
Shout out to everybody. This is a great profession. And I don't know, we just... Hopefully the darker days are behind us. And, you know, peace and love.
Triple C.
Blessed out of peacemakers.
All right, everybody. It's episode 103. Listen, season 3 is getting crazy. Getting crazy. We appreciate you. Keep telling a friend to tell a friend. Be safe. We love you. Be well. See y'all next week.
Until I find a way, the only words I know. The views and opinions expressed on the Silverback Podcast are those of the hosts, producers, and or the persons appearing on the program. And do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the federal, state, or local government. This includes, but not exclusive to, the Department of Defense and or the Baltimore City Police Department. Until I say the only words I
know that you, until I... The Silverback Chronicles podcast with Dre, Big H, and Triple C. Hit the subscribe button, like, and comment.